That was Passacaglia in C minor by Fred Grahmann, of course, at the American Church of Paris. Next, we'll feature an arrangement by Sandy Ethan of Lo, How a Rose Air Blooming. Next, an arrangement from one of our younger composers, become quite prolific. He's written some great stuff, always includes some fun malloding in Matt Compton's work. This is his arrangement of Crown Him with Many Crowns.
Thank you.
knows what state Sandy Ethan is from? In the green shirt, do you know back in the back? Wisconsin, exactly. So one of my prized possessions at the Raleigh Ringer building is a gift she gave me when she came and led our festival. I have my own autographed Sandy Ethan cheesehead. Say that mainly for your benefit, Tim. This is another wonderful arrangement. She's taken two pieces, combined them together. What wondrous love, and were you there?
Thank you.
I know all of you have played the music of Jason Krug, a wonderful, wonderful, relatively new composer, but has really come into his own. Rather, we used to do a lot of demonstration recordings. Jason's pieces are always just a little bit different, but that's what makes them creative and so unique. We have a saying in the Raleigh Ringers, Andy knows as well as he does our recording. As we're recording, we ask the question, is it wrong or is it Krug? That's what we say. This is a new piece to me. It's really, really fine work, again, by Jason. Interesting techniques and interesting chordal structures in here. An arrangement of praise to the Lord, the Almighty.
Thank you.
Do you ever have that happen in your bell choir? The only time they got the ending right was that time. You guys are awesome. Unfortunately, they saw the look of surprise. Where did they come from? Before we play our final piece, I want to thank our guest bass bell ringers, Andy and Dale. Thank you for letting us borrow them and borrow some of the bells. They came in yesterday afternoon, one rehearsal, and got it all down. So, and I also want to thank the entire group for all your attention during the many hours, putting up with me with my little bit of cough here, but thank you for working so very hard. Let's give it up for these guys. Yeah, one more piece we want to present. This is a work of Dr. Payne's, and I'd like him to introduce the piece and tell us a little bit about what was behind the creation of this amazing, amazing piece of music.
Thanks, Dave. What do I do?
Who cares?
First of all, thank you for playing it. It's an honor to have Dave conducting it. This was a work that I wrote in 1980, maybe 81, after the hostage situation in Iran. I, along with many of you who are the age where you remember this event, will remember I sat in front of the TV and watched the hostages that were released come into Washington in a caravan. And it was a very moving moment. And that day, while I was watching them, I heard this melody going around in my head, and I thought, I need to just write this down. And about 7 hours later, I finished, oh God, beneath your guiding hand. I didn't just write down the melody, I wrote the whole thing. And that's rare. Most composers, I don't write a piece in one day, but I was moved. And so the first part is in a minor mode, and it portrays perhaps the horror and the sadness that these hostages felt at a time when they were alienated from each other and didn't even know whether some of them were being murdered or were still there. It goes then into a more joyful section, which you'll hear, which is the homecoming for those that were released. And then it goes back to a more serene, introspective type of portion of the piece that perhaps reminds us of the POWs and the MIAs that are still there, and also to just all over the world, people who are held hostage in so many different ways. And right near the end, I go into a major key, I go into C major for just a brief few measures. And that was my portrayal of maybe perhaps a ray of hope that this kind of thing will stop. And here we are, 40 years later, still war goes on. At the very end, and so that ray of hope does eventually end up coming to three chords at the end, three dissonant chords, each one a little louder than the previous. And I guess I wrote that because it was a bittersweet ending. We were happy that these hostages came home, but we still must remember those that didn't, and that this horrible thing called war continues. So I appreciate your playing this for us. Thank you.
The title is O God Beneath Your Guiding Hand.